What's going on, everybody? Gem Mint here. On today's Omnibus haul video, I got a really good question from Shawn Manaher, who asked, do Omnibus hold their value? Now, as I started to type the response, I thought, man, this is actually a pretty good video topic because it's not just a quick yes or no answer. So let's jump into it. Before we get started, though, make sure you're subscribed to the channel. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss a video. We are giving away a Spider-Man premium format exclusive statue by Sideshow Collectibles once we hit 125,000 subscribers. Stay tuned to the end of the video, and I'll give you more details on how to enter. So let's start off with Sean's question here. Now, the great thing about the Omnibus format, besides having the entire run or entire event with all the tie-ins in one hardcover book, you could buy these things below their cover price through retail sites online. So we have a sponsor, cheapgraphicnovels.com. They sell these type of books up to 50% off cover price. They also have great packaging, fast shipping, excellent customer service. They even have a bargain bin where you can actually get books up to 90% off. And also, if you guys decide to shop there, if you mention me in the memo at checkout on your first order, the next order will have free shipping if you're in the U.S. So sites like Cheap Graphic Novels, there are other sites out there that when Omnibus are first released, that's when you could get them for their cheapest. I've yet to find a hobby like this. I wish that statues were available for 50% off their retail price when they first come out. But for whatever reason in the book market, that's a thing. I mean, even if you look at Amazon. So Omnis typically run anywhere from like $75 to $150 for their retail cover price. And like I said, when they're first released, you can buy them greatly discounted. So for me, that's a no-brainer. If you're able to get something for 50% off, you're good either way. It's not going to really go down in value. Now, whether or not they hold their value, let's break it down like this. Once those retail sites run out of their stock, then you can no longer buy them through Cheap Graphic Novels or Amazon. Let's say they're all sold out. Then your next best bet is to go to a local comic shop or even a bookstore like Barnes & Noble, and you would have to buy those books for cover price. So you're no longer getting the discounted rate, you're now at cover price. Now what happens once those stores, those LCSs or bookstores run out of their stock and the book is no longer in print, meaning they aren't sending out batches to retailers, then you're at the mercy of the aftermarket, and that's when books start not only holding value, but appreciating in value. So those books that you got for 50% off could potentially be 200% more than retail price once they hit the aftermarket. Now, with popular titles, more likely than not, they're gonna go out of print and they're gonna start selling for more on the aftermarket. I think even like event books like War of the Realms is selling for astronomical prices on eBay right now. I want to say upwards of $300, which is like a 100% increase. Now, there are some titles that I don't think will ever really go out of stock. I think that's reserved more for those compilation type books, whether it's a compilation of number ones or issue zeros or just by maybe a certain artist. Those typically don't really hold value. But if it's any kind of event or pretty well-known character, chances are it's going to eventually go out of print and eventually only be available in the aftermarket. Now, here's the caveat. Here's the thing. You can't just bank on every one of your Omnibus appreciating in value and just always being a really good investment, because what happens with these books is that they can get reprinted. And with Marvel Comics' track record recently, they're reprinting so many out-of-print books that have been going for well over retail for years now. So when you get a new printing and it's available through Cheap Graphic Novels or Amazon or whoever, and it's available for up to 50% off, why would anybody go buy that first printing for 100 or more percent greater than retail? They just don't. In this world, we really just want the book because we want the story. The first printing, second printing, fifth printing, that doesn't really matter. So it's a dangerous game if you're buying to keep, because Marvel can reprint. DC does as well, but Marvel's much better with it. And those books that were once worth $300 are now worth the same as what that new printing is worth because it's available for, like I said, up to 50% off. Now, Marvel hasn't reprinted every book. There still are a lot of what we call whales or hard to find books that are out there that are not solicited for reprints yet. Off the top of my head, I'm thinking about stuff like Invincible Iron Man, Volume 1, Volume 2, X-Men by Stan Lee and Jack Kirby, Volume 1 and 2. Now, Jonathan Hickman's Fantastic Four was on that grail or that whale list for a long time, but has just been announced for a reprint for Volume 1, so you know Volume 2 is coming. And that makes me wary about people who are holding on to the Avengers by Jonathan Hickman Omnis, because although those are out of print and selling for a lot right now, they're probably going to get reprinted eventually. But you know what I've seen time and time again? A second printing comes along. It's available for, you know, up to 50% off. But then the same thing happens as what happened with the first printing. It goes out of stock, then out of print, and then it's aftermarket prices. So the books will hold value. They'll go down if a reprinting is announced. Once it's out of print, out of stock, not available anywhere but the aftermarket, it goes back up. So I do think overall, they definitely hold their value. They're never really going to go less than you buying it for 50% off cover price, unless it's something obscure like the Muppets or some type of compilation omnibus. I think for the most part, you're going to at least be able to get what you paid for, but there's a greater chance it will appreciate. And you just got to know when to sell if you ever decide to sell them. Me personally, these are the collectibles that I don't really intend to sell, although I should be selling X-Men Volume 1 and Volume 2, because you know they got to reprint it closer to the time when the movies come out. But I just don't want to be without those books in my collection. Like, those are the type of books that if I greatly purge the Omnis, those would be keepers. You know what I'm saying? So I don't really see myself selling it just to make a quick profit to buy it later down the line, although it is a great way to fund the hobby. Anyway, I think that pretty much covers it. Yes, they do hold value. Yes, there are ebbs and flows depending on reprints, but for the most part, I think you're good to go. Let me know what you think about this topic in the comments below, or if you have any other type of questions that you think warrant their own videos like this, I'd be happy to consider it. Like I said, we're giving away this Spider-Man premium format exclusive by Sideshow once we hit the next subscriber milestone of 125,000. All you got to do is be subscribed to this channel, hit the notification bell so you don't miss a video, leave a like and a comment on this video and any other video where you heard me promote this giveaway. Once we hit the milestone, we'll do our regular Sunday morning live streams, pick a random video where I promoted this giveaway, and use a random YouTube comment generator to draw a worldwide winner. If you guys want to support the channel in other ways, you got to check out our partners at Street Level Hero, SLHLA.com. They have exclusive variants. They dropped three this week, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. They all had brand new exclusives that you could only get through them, and you can use the code GemMint to save 10% on any of those books, any item on the store, and you can use that code anytime you shop there. It's a great help to the channel. You get some great exclusive variants as well, so go ahead and check them out. I appreciate you watching, but don't go anywhere. Check out my Dropping Gems playlist to the right, where I have these types of videos in a nice playlist for you. Stay minty fresh. Peace.